Hello guys, welcome all of you to today's Farmcast. And today guys, we'll discuss not five drugs of choice, but one disorder, that is hypertension, but it is more than five drugs of choice discussion, right? And plus I'll discuss few questions asked by the students, but that I'll keep to the last as always. And hypertension guys, to begin with, you know, the first line drugs in hypertension, these are three classes, ACE inhibitors or ARB, calcium channel blockers, and thiazides. So if it is a young patient that is less than equal to 55 years, we prefer ACE inhibitors or ARBs because, you know, the renin is high or they have a hyperreninemic hypertension. Whereas if it is an old person, more than 55 years, renin is low. So I go for CCB as drug of choice, calcium channel blocker. Now in both these classes, if there is no response, then I can keep on adding other classes like thiazides or other drugs. And if the patient does not respond to three drugs, minimum of three drugs, and one has to be a diuretic, then I call it as a case of resistant hypertension. And guys, what is the drug of choice for resistant hypertension? Think, what is the drug of choice for resistant hypertension? So guys, the drug of choice is spironolactone. Why? Because in resistant hypertension, spironolactone is high, right? Now we'll discuss about hypertension associated with comorbidities. Now remember, if there is a patient of hypertension with diabetes mellitus, chronic kidney disease, scleroderma, or nephrotic syndrome, then the preferred class of drugs are ACE inhibitors, ARBs, because I can decrease your proteinuria, or they have nephroprotective effect in diabetes mellitus, CKD, nephrotic syndrome, and in scleroderma, right? But if there is a patient who has hypertension with angina, or he already had an attack of MI, hyperthyroidism, migraine, anxiety with somatic manifestations like tremor, patient of essential tremor, patient of atrial fibrillation or flutter, and he's having hypertension, then your drug of choice is beta blockers. It's very commonly asked, guys, very commonly asked, right? Next, if there is a patient who has hypertension with osteoporosis, then what is the drug of choice? Think. Now, obviously, I would go for a diuretic that causes hypercalcemia. So, which first-line antihypertensive drug causes hypercalcemia? It is thiazides, isn't it? So, hypertension with osteoporosis, guys, we go for thiazides. All right, if it is a case of hypertension with Raynaud's disease, it's very simple, guys. Raynaud's disease, drug of choice are calcium channel blockers. So, if it is a case of hypertension with Raynaud's, I would rather directly go for calcium channel blockers, right? If it is a case of hypertension with benign prostate hyperplasia, BPH, or hypertension with dyslipidemia, then what should I follow? What should I use? It's an easy one, guys. Alpha blockers, alpha 1 blockers, because alpha 1 blockers, they can dilate the prostatic urethra, plus alpha blockers, they have the ability to decrease the bad lipid, that is LDL, and that is how they would be effective in dyslipidemia as well as, right? Now, what if they ask you about drug of choice for hypertensive emergency? Guys, remember, currently, the drug of choice for hypertensive emergency is intravenous nicardipine. Whereas, hypertensive urgency, the drug of choice is clonidine. Now, something else. What if it is a case of hypertension in pregnancy or hypertensive emergency in pregnancy? The answer is same, guys. Labetalol. The route is different. Hypertension in pregnancy, oral labetalol. Hypertensive emergency in pregnancy, intravenous labetalol. So guys, that is what we have to discuss today in this section of drug of choice and all the drugs which are related to hypertension, right? So guys, now I'll come down to your doubt section where you guys do ask me some of your doubts. And one of my student, he has asked me a doubt. Syed Wise has asked, sir, should there be any specific changes in preparation strategy now that all central institute exams, they have been clubbed into INICET for AIIMS, JIPMER, PGI? I don't think you have gone through my tweet or in my Facebook or Instagram. Everywhere I posted yesterday a small post, and my post goes like this, that the stadium, the pitch, the umpires, they might change, but the game is still cricket, right? They won't ask you to play football in a cricket match. That was my post yesterday regarding this INICET, which means what, guys? Does not matter what they'll ask you. I mean, what would be the pattern of exam? The medical science is not gonna change. They won't ask you about civics, history, or geography. So do not worry about that part. Now, this has been seen always. Changes will keep on coming, guys. I've seen many changes in the examination pattern, and that keeps on changing, but the essence remains same, right? They will still keep on asking you MCQs on hypokalemia, hyperkalemia, diabetes, HOCM. So these are still the hotcake topics. They are not gonna change. So do not make any change in your preparation. Keep focusing on the high yield areas. And it depends upon, students. There are two kinds of students. One, I have seen, they're pretty serious. They're damn serious about the Central Institute exams. For you guys, you can just keep on preparing the way you are preparing and try to finish at least one revision before the Central Institute exams, right? Because if you'll not finish the revision, then there is a high risk that you'll not perform well in these exams. So one revision has to be finished before this. And why I'm saying this, because you usually have time for revision for the NEET exam, but many of us, we do not get time to revise before the Central Institute exams. So that is one thing you need to keep in mind. Otherwise, it's the same exam, they'll ask the same medical science, so there is nothing to be worried about, guys. Don't get anxious about these unnecessary stuffs. Now, you should be worried about how am I gonna deal with that revision before the Central Institute exam. That is gonna help you. These are unnecessary anxiety, right? And Bhuvnayar Nagesh has asked me, sir, what would be the pattern of INICET? See, if I knew what would be the pattern of INICET, I would have definitely told you guys, because nobody knows this as of now, what would be the pattern. But certainly you cannot rule out MCQs. Multiple choice questions would be there. And in this current scenario, I don't think they're going to do any kind of, now this is my hunch, that any kind of experiment, they'll just want to get the exam over with, right? And get the residents who are gonna work for the coronavirus patients. So I don't think that they're gonna do much experiment and change the pattern in this exam, at least. Nizam Khan has asked one doubt. Sir, I have a bit of doing exercise for half an hour, and am I wasting my time? Should I stop doing exercise? Absolutely not, Nizam. Absolutely not. I mean, this is something you should do. Why? Because you're getting free endorphins. I told one in one of my farmcasts, right? If you feel depressed, if you are not feeling good, then you can always do something you are passionate about, you love about. So doing exercise or jogging or playing your video game for half an hour, if it is giving you a good mood, then it's great, right? No, just sitting for 10 hours and being pathetic and the productivity is low, that is not gonna help. So rather, what you need to do is you need to take a break for half an hour, do whatever you love to do, and then come back fresh, and then you can continue your study, guys. So please continue doing it. And even just before the exam, half an hour is not no big deal. It would be rather helping you, because if you do some exercise, you'll have a good sleep and you'll get up fresh in the morning, and you can continue that tempo. Shreya Sharma has asked one doubt. Sir, while reviewing the grand test, should I only see the questions I did wrong or review all the questions? Also, should I read just the explanation given with the question or look through the topic from the notes completely? See, Shreya, I'll tell you on a lighter note. Now, this is a proverb that I use mostly and in a funny way. So, it's a Hindi proverb, and that is, Bhikari ko bheek jitna mile theek. Iska matlab kya hai? What do you mean by this? Is I usually, I apply this proverb whenever I have a crunch of time. For example, I was also in the same dilemma where you are when I was preparing. And solving those 300 questions, those explanations, it was a difficult task. But I had restricted myself that this is the one day that I'm having is GT day, and I would do as much as I can. If I'm not able to do some 40-50 questions, I'll just forget about them. I'll make peace with myself that they do not exist for me. Otherwise, I could not have moved forward, right, with my preparation. So what you need to do is begin with those questions which you have done wrong first, go through the explanations, and then try to go through the others and fix the time. Fix the time and do as much as you are able to do in that time. Otherwise, forget about it. right? Not to worry, continue with your revision of your notes. Notes are most important. All right, another student, Ritvik Patnaik, has asked, sir, please tell us about some books that students can read, should read pharmacology. See, books are never, you should never read books cover to cover for competitive exams. Those who claim to read books cover to cover for competitive exams, probably they have read only cover, right? So here, mostly in competitive exams, we focus on notes and videos. But if you are an undergrad student, right, you have a second year student and you're asking me about which book to study for pharmacology, then I would advise you to go for Katzen. Katzen is the best book in the market for undergrads. Of course, Goodman Gilman is top notch, but it would have become too much for an undergrad. Even PG students, they sometimes don't study Goodman Gilman. So go through Katzen. Katzen will, you know, solve most of your purpose. And another student, Madhulita Patnaik, has asked, sir, would you add the lecture on new video? See, lecture on new videos, I don't know if I'll be recording a lecture on new video this year, but certainly in a month or so I will be uploading a PDF in the Merolinx group, where there would be new drugs of last 3 years, not only this year, 3 years, and not all the drugs, because if I give you all the drugs, it would become 150 drugs, which you will die mugging up. So I'll give you only 25 to 30 drugs, new drugs for the last 3 years, which are high yield. Means, you know, see, the new drugs, they always love to ask new drugs which are for TB or malaria, or it is a groundbreaking drug, like a drug was Edaravone, was approved for multiple sclerosis, because for many decades we had only one drug, Riluzole. So new drug, they ask you mostly if they are antimicrobials or if they make a drastic change in the treatment of a disease. So guys, that's all for today. If you have such kind of doubts, you can always let me know in the comment box. Guys, I'll more than happy to accommodate your doubts in the Pharmcast. So take care, guys. Bye bye. This was Dr. Ranjan with you.